Want smoother, more efficient motion control? BLDC motors deliver precision, reliability, and energy savings in diverse applications. But when it comes to designing a BLDC motor control system, that requires integrating a robust controller to manage power delivery, monitor motor performance, provide necessary protections, plus the know-how to do it. In this tech guide brought to you by Mouser Electronics, we'll explore how to design a high-performance BLDC motor drive using the Qorvo PAC55710 72-volt BLDC motor controller and driver. We'll also highlight its key features, applications, and best practices for optimizing motor performance. By the end, you'll have the insights needed to build a reliable and efficient BLDC motor drive. So let's get started.
Step 1. Understanding BLDC motor control requirements.
We're going to start with the basics and talk requirements. Before selecting a motor controller, you'll need to define your system requirements, such as voltage and current ratings, to ensure compatibility. Proper commutation requires precise phase voltage switching using pulse width modulation or PWM. Additionally, robust protection features such as overcurrent, overvoltage, and thermal safeguards enhance system reliability. Moreover, real-time motor control demands a microcontroller with sufficient processing power. The Qorvo PAC55710 meets all of these requirements with its integrated system-on-chip solution. It's excellent at simplifying BLDC motor drive design while enhancing efficiency and safety.
Step 2. Implementing the Qorvo PAC55710 in a BLDC drive system.
Let's do a quick dive into why the PAC55710 is a perfect fit for BLDC motor control. The device integrates several key components vital for efficient motor operation. These include 150 MHz ARM Cortex M4F microcontroller for real-time motor control algorithms. It also features a 15-channel PWM engine to efficiently drive the motor phases and high and low side gate drivers to control external MOSFETs. Additionally, it provides advanced protection mechanisms such as cycle-by-cycle current limiting and overcurrent shutdown. With all of those features, it gives designers a sense of comfort as you know the PAC55710 is delivering robust protection and optimized performance.
Power management and supply configuration.
Let's talk a little about power management and supply configuration. The PAC55710 operates within a 5.2 volt to 72 volt input power range, making it suitable for both industrial and battery-powered applications. It includes an integrated Buck-Sepik DC to DC controller to generate stable power supplies for microcontroller and external components. So let's cover how to configure the power supply. To set up the power supply, connect the 5.2 volt to 72 volt input voltage to the designated pins and use an external N-channel FET for power conversion. Lastly, make sure the 5-volt 200 milliampere system supply is available to power the microcontroller. Following these steps will ensure a stable, reliable power supply for optimal system performance.
Step 3. Motor control implementation.
BLDC motors require precise PWM signals to control the three-phase bridge inverter, and the PAC55710 provides the essential components for this task. It includes three high side and three low side gate drivers, along with a 15-channel PWM engine for phase voltage control. Now let's take a look at how to configure the PWM signals. To configure the PWM signals, set the frequency based on the motor's electrical characteristics, typically between 10 kHz and 50 kHz, and adjust the dead time to prevent shoot-through currents. Complementary PWM signals should be used for high side and low side transistors. By configuring the PWM signals correctly, you can ensure efficient motor control and prevent potential issues like shoot-through currents. Accurate current sensing can't be overstated for effective motor control and protection, and the PAC55710 has this fully covered. It includes three differential programmable gain amplifiers with adjustable gain, four signal ended PGAs for flexible current measurements, and VDS sensing for real-time phase voltage monitoring. Advanced CBC protection is also available to limit overcurrent conditions. Okay, let's now discuss implementing overcurrent protection. To implement overcurrent protection, first connect phase current shunt resistors to the PAC55710's differential PGAs. Next, enable cycle-by-cycle current limiting to adjust the PWM duty cycle during high current events. Finally, configure programmable overcurrent shutdown to prevent hardware damage in the event of a fault. These steps will help you successfully implement overcurrent protection and protect your system from potential faults.
Step 4, implementing motor position and speed control.
Now let's explore how the PAC55710 handles rotor position detection for efficient commutation. BLDC motors require rotor position information for proper commutation. The PAC55710 supports both sensorless back EMF control and Hall sensor-based control. For sensorless operation, it uses ADC measurements for back EMF control, while Hall sensor feedback is provided through GPIO or serial interfaces. Let's now go over the steps on how to enable sensorless operation. To enable sensorless operation, we'll follow three steps. First, use a simultaneous sample and hold feature to capture all three phase voltages at once. Next, process the sampled signals to estimate rotor position, and finally, dynamically adjust PWM duty cycles based on the back EMF readings. By following these steps, you can effectively enable sensorless operation and optimize motor performance.
Step 5, communication and system integration.
The PAC55710 supports various serial interfaces for seamless system integration, enabling real-time data exchange with external controllers or monitoring systems. Additionally, it provides 25 GPIOs for extra system control signals. For instance, in an industrial robotic application, the CAN interface can be used to communicate motor status in diagnostics to a central controller, enhancing overall system performance and monitoring. These communication and integration features make the PAC55710 a versatile solution for efficient and connected motor control systems.
Step 6, system diagnostics and fault handling.
Motor drive systems need to detect and respond to faults quickly to prevent damage. And the PAC55710 offers essential features to ensure effective fault handling. It includes a windowed watchdog timer to monitor the system for unexpected behavior. Additionally, it features programmable comparator hysteresis and blanking to filter out noise and false triggers. Now let's examine how to implement effective fault handling. To implement fault handling, enable the watchdog timer to reset the system in case of software malfunctions. Next, configure the programmable comparators to detect voltage and current abnormalities. Finally, log fault conditions via UART or CAN for system monitoring. With these capabilities, the PAC55710 enhances system reliability and protection.
Step 7, testing and optimization.
Once the hardware and firmware are configured, the final step is to test the system by running the motor at different speeds and loads. This includes monitoring current, voltage, and temperature data, as well as fine-tuning control parameters for efficiency and stability. In applications like e-mobility, optimizing the motor startup sequence and commutation logic is important for ensuring smooth operation and extending battery life. This testing process helps achieve optimal performance in the system. The Qorvo PAC55710 provides a highly integrated and efficient solution for BLDC motor control. By leveraging its high-speed microcontroller, configurable PWM engine, and advanced protection features, designers can create robust and energy-efficient motor drives. These features make it ideal for applications in industrial automation, small appliances, and electric mobility. We hope you found this tech guide helpful and wish you success on your project design. To learn more about the Qorvo PAC55710 and explore other resources for your project, please visit Mouser.com or click the link in the description below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.